Infrared. Pretty popular effect looks something like this, and we're gonna create this today in this video, unless of course you're watching this at 2359, which would transition it over to tomorrow. Anyway, the idea here is very simple. To create this effect, we need to invert the colors without making the image look like a negative. You see, when we press Ctrl or Command I or invert the photo, the bright skies become black and the dark areas become white. We don't want that. We just want to preserve the inverted colors, which look amazing. So how do we do this? Let's find out. So without any further ado, let's get started. Back in the magical world of Photoshop, and if you want to go ahead and download this photo and follow along, you know what to do, check the links in the description. The first thing we need to do here is to invert the colors. We will invert this by using an inversion adjustment layer, not by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose invert. Now, this is an adjustment layer, and there's an advantage to it. We'll discuss it later. But right now, we just want to preserve the colors. So we just want to keep the colors, right? What is colors? Where can we find color? Blend modes. So change the blend mode of the invert adjustment layer from normal to color. This will make sure that the adjustment layer only affects the color of the layer beneath it, not the luminosity or the brightness. So that is why we have kept the inverted color. But this still needs some work. This doesn't look amazing. Now, before we move forward, some of you might be asking, Unmesh, why did you make an invert adjustment layer? Why didn't you just make a copy of the background and then press Ctrl or Command I and then converted the blend mode to color? That would have worked too. Yes, that would have, but there's a reason why I did this. Let me show you something. Let's say we made a copy of the background layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J, and then we press Ctrl or Command I, and then we change the blend mode from normal to color, right? This creates the same effect as this one, right? But we didn't do that. Why? Here's why. Let's say you're in the color layer or you're in the background layer and you want to move the pixels around for some reason. So let's say you want to remove this branch right there or something like that. So I'm going to go to the clone stamp tool or any tool like that. I'm going to take a sample right there and let's say we remove that. So right now we've removed the branch, but the color of the branch stays. Why? Because it's still there in the color layer, right? We also have to remove it from the color layer, only then it will work. So that is the issue with that. It's highly destructive. So instead, if we create an adjustment layer, let's just go back. If we just create a simple adjustment layer with the invert adjustment and then change the blend mode to color, whatever you do, whatever pixels you move or whatever adjustments you do here, it will adapt to that. Because the invert adjustment layer stores a virtual copy, which will change as you change the pixels in the background layer. I hope that makes sense. Let's move forward. The next thing that we're gonna add is a channel mixer. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose channel mixer. Now, what we wanna do is to reduce the red from the red areas. So right now, we are targeting the red channel. Have a look at the output channel right there. This just means that we are targeting the channel that we have selected. One of the three channels, red, green, blue. Now, if we choose red, it is now locked to red, which means that all these three sliders will do is increase or decrease the amount of red. That's it. Now, just to emphasize, I'm going to repeat that again. All these three sliders will do is increase or decrease the amount of red. Now, you might ask, there's a green slider, there's a blue slider. Aren't they supposed to control green or blue color? No, they are just supposed to increase or decrease the value of red in the green areas and the blue areas respectively. That's it. And the red one controls the value or the amount of red in the red areas. So once we have selected red or green or blue, all three sliders will just increase or decrease their amount in red, green or blue areas. So let's go ahead and select red, and we want to reduce the amount of red in the red areas. So I'm going to set it to 0, right? But now the balance is off because the total should be 100%. So now to compensate for it, I'm just going to increase the green to 100. Now the green is kind of too much. It looks kind of yellowish. So let's go to the green channel. Now in the green channel, we will do the opposite. Let's decrease the green to 0. And increase the green in the red areas. Why? Because it's total magenta, right? And what's the opposite of magenta? Green. So if we just increase the green in the red areas, it will be better. Now we are getting the look that we were going for. but it's totally green at the moment. We'll fix that later. Just keep in mind that the total must be 100. But again, this is art. You can experiment with it. So if you decrease the blue, it looks nice, doesn't it? So you can experiment with all the channels, all the sliders. That's totally upon you, but I'm going to leave it at that. Now, as you can see, the colors are off a little bit. So we need to target some colors. And what is the best adjustment layer to target the colors and manipulate them? Selective color. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then this time choose selective color at the very bottom. Now, first of all, let's target the reds. So what do you want to do in the red areas? Do you want to increase or decrease the cyan or the magenta or yellow or black? What do you want to do? So you can manipulate any color in any which way you want using selective color. Now, at this moment, you might think there is no red slider. There's no green or blue slider. No problem at all. If you just decrease cyan, you will get red because cyan is the opposite of red. Magenta is the opposite of green and yellow is the opposite of blue. So if you take cyan to the left, it will just increase the reds in the red areas. So I'm going to leave it at that. Magenta, let's decrease it just a little bit. Yellow, black. Now the red is not creating much of an effect. Let's move to the yellow channel. And this time it might work. Now we don't want any of the yellows. So it's looking very yellowish. So let's decrease the yellows all the way to the left. If we increase the magenta, does it look nice? Wow, it does look so much better. So I'm going to keep it at that. What about cyan? It's creating this nice blue effect. I'm going to keep it increased. What about blacks? Make sure that you're working with relative. That way, the results are not too harsh. Now, if you choose absolute, you will see the results are a little harsh. So relative is kind of soft. So this looks very, very nice. The next thing that you can play with right here is neutrals. This will target all of the midtones. So let's increase the cyan here. Wow, just a touch. Magenta does look nice. There you are. It does create such an exciting effect. You can always go back to the settings and go back to yellows and the other colors if you think something is off and you need some change. So let's say I want to add a little bit of the yellow and want some change here. I can easily do that. I just want to make the image look a little brighter. So let's change the sliders just a little bit. Let's adjust the neutrals a little bit. So let's go to the neutrals. I'm going to set it to about 50. Let's set this one to something like that. Keep in mind, we are reducing the blacks in the neutrals, which means we are reducing the blacks in the midtones. In other words, we are reducing the blacks, we are making it brighter. Just the opposite, right? So let's keep it at about minus 48 or 46. There you go, it's creating that kind of a look. If you want more colors, you can of course increase the magenta and get more colors right there. There you are, it's interesting. If you're editing a photo in Photoshop, contrast cannot be ignored. And if you've watched PiXimperfect before, you know my bias. Curves, it's always curves all the way. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves for contrast. So what is contrast? Brightening the brights and darkening the darks. So you're going to create a point on the right hand side of the curves because the right side represents the highlights, left side represents the shadows, and middle represents midtones. So click and drag it up something like this. And we're going to click and drag it down to create the contrast. If you look at the right hand side of the curves, there's a lot of space right there. Let's fill it up. Bring the slider to the left. There you go. And now we are creating an interesting curves contrast. Here's the before, here's the after. Nice contrast, but we still want some fade in here. To add some fade, let's add one more curves adjustment layer. Click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves again. Now just decrease the highlights just a little bit, and then increase the shadows. Just a flat fade. If you want, you can also create a point on the left-hand side and bring it down, just for the fade effect. This looks nice. Now, it's time for us to add some color to it. And one of the easiest ways to do it is by using a color lookup table. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose color lookup. But again, if I choose something like the late sunset, because it's late sunset, as it seems in this image. So if we choose late sunset, I don't really like the colors, but I love the luminosity on this thing. I love how it's managing the brightness, adding a little bit soft contrast. So we want to keep the luminosity, but not the colors. So simply change the blend mode from normal to luminosity. Look at it. Here's the before, here's the after. Nice, right? So decrease the opacity to about 40% because that was kind of too much. Here's the before, here's the after, that evening feeling. That's nice. But as soon as we did that, the image looks a little dark. So let's go back to the curves beneath it and bring this point up. because it was looking very dark. So we're going to keep it a little up, something like this. That's much better. Now to boost the colors even more, why not try one more adjustment layer? And this time we will literally boost the colors. And to do that, click on the adjustment layer icon, and this time we're going to choose vibrance, but at the very top. So make sure that you have selected the topmost adjustment layer so that now when we create the vibrance adjustment layer by clicking on the adjustment layer icon and choosing vibrance, it's created on top of everything. All right, let's just simply increase the vibrance at about 40%. That looks decent. And here we are. Here's the before, here's the after, just a little boosted color. Now, just for this particular image, if we zoom in tight, have a look at the bands at the top. It's kind of distracting, and we have made so many manipulations with color that you begin to see those bands in the sky. There's an effect I'm going to show which would look very nice with images like this, and that is grain. And the way you create it is very simple. Press Ctrl+Shift+N, Command+Shift+N on a Mac. The new layer dialog box will show up. You can just name it grain and change the blend mode from normal to overlay. Make sure you check fill with overlay neutral color. That way it will fill it with 50% gray. You know what happens with 50% gray? Whenever you choose the blend mode overlay, it hides everything which is 50% gray. So let's go ahead and make sure this is checked and hit OK. Now go to filter, convert for smart filters so that we can change the values of the filter later. Hit OK again. And now go to filter, noise, and then add noise. We're going to add 35, make sure it's uniform, make sure monochromatic, hit OK. You can also try Gaussian, that's totally upon you. Now we don't want noise in the highlight areas. So how do we remove that from the highlights? Double click on the right hand side of the layer. Take the slider of the underlying layer from right to left. At this moment it's very harsh, so hold the Alt key or the Option key, click on the slider to break it apart and make a very soft transition. There you go. Hit OK once you're satisfied. That way, the grain is not in the very highlight areas, and as the areas begin to go darker, the grain increases, the way it actually happens in a real photograph. So there you go. That's how to create a super cool infrared effect in Photoshop. All you have to keep in mind is this: how to preserve inverted colors. And the concept here is very simple. You create an invert adjustment layer, or you simply make a copy and invert it. That way, it inverts everything. But if you just want to keep the colors, change the blend mode to color. Everything we did after that was just an enhancement of color, whether it was selective color, channel mixer, color lookup, that's totally upon you. I hope this video helped you in some way or the other, and if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tip, trick, or tutorial. I would like to take this moment to thank all these nice and amazing people for supporting this channel on Patreon and helping keep PiXimperfect free for everybody forever. Thanks so much for all your support. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.